Minasan, konnichiwa. Today we review game which was released on PC and PlayStation 2, Oni, and it was created by Bungie. Yes, that Bungie. Game was heavily influenced by Ghost in the Shell series, and you can tell it right away by looking at the main characters. Besides that, game has pretty stunning opening movie, which was made in the anime style. But story in the game nowhere near Ghost in the Shell, even its games. Here you follow Kanoko, police officer who fights with different crime organizations, and supported by droid Shinatama and her boss Griffin. But during mid-game story making 180 turn, and now you need to discover Kanoko's past and stop your brother from destroying humanity. Story presented in very simple cutscenes between levels and in few in-game dialogues. But to my surprise, in one moment you even have a choice in the story and can shoot your former boss or walk away. And depending on that, you will have support during last boss fight or not. Plus, few times story becomes very dark, which also was unexpected. In gameplay it is action game, with third person view. You have different guns and can shoot from them, but most of the time will fight with enemy bare hand. So it is kind of beat 'em up game. You have punch and kick, and can do simple combos from them. You can attack during jumps, or roll away from enemies, or even ender lasers, but I almost never used it. You can run and throw enemies while doing that. Plus, you have two special attacks, which are very powerful, but hard to execute. You can crouch, and during that walk behind enemies' back, unnoticed, but it is easier to just beat them all up. You also can pick up some weapons from defeated enemies, or by exploring levels, like pistols, machine guns, and even plasma guns with rocket launchers. But ammo really scarce, and it is hard to actually hit enemy with it. Plus, you have different ammo for normal and plasma guns, but if you can choose, always go for plasma. At least you can aim with it, and homing rocket, ultimate weapon. Even this wonders a bit, and can damage you too. And you can carry only one gun with you, and if enemy shot you before you took his weapon, most likely it won't have any bullets left in it. Besides weapons and ammo, sometimes you can pick up health packs from enemies, but you need to use them manually, and health restores not instantly, which can be a problem during heated fights. But if you will restore your health at maximum, you will start glowing, and for some time your attacks will become much more powerful. Sometime in levels you can meet friendly characters, and even can save them from enemies, and after it they can give you more ammo or health packs, but if you will hit them, they not gonna talk with you. In addition to all that, you also can pick up optical camouflage, which can make you invisible for some time, or special shield, which can protect you from bullets, but normal attacks still will damage you. This shield very helpful, because without it, even most weak enemy with a pistol can take out almost all your lives. And if you will face few of them at the same time, you are pretty much finished. Yes, you can hit enemy, and he can lose his weapon, but he also can pick his weapon back, where another enemy can fight and pick it. And enemies very different too, from very weak walkers to simple soldiers, and even heavy armored soldiers. Some even can fight very well, and if you will face 3 or 4 of them at once, you also finished, and it isn't easy to lure them out by one, because if enemy will see you, he can run to you across all map, so you must be very careful always. Some enemies even can run towards alarm panels to activate it, and it is your priority to stop them, or even more heavily armed enemies will show up. Game also has few bosses, but they are not that great, just same as usual soldiers, which you need to defeat in hand-to-hand combat. They just have bigger health bar, or you need to activate 4 panels to shoot down computer, and avoid lasers during it. And talking about activating panels, in all levels you will do pretty much only this. Go to a panel, activate it, open new door, and go to the next panel. Levels themselves are nothing special, and mostly set in some buildings or warehouses, and they are very huge, like a lot. In most of them you will see big open spaces, which are pointless, few levels especially bad. Design too, copy-pasted, and you can run on few same floors for 30 minutes, and one level repeats twice. Good thing at least one interesting level exists, your dream, where you will face a bit strange enemies, but this level very short. and checkpoints on this level is very rare. You can defeat 15 enemies, clear a few floors, and fall into a pit because of unlucky attack, and will need to redo everything. Or can catch a bullet from a sniper who sits on the different side of the map, which will defeat you in one shot. Such moments very frustrating, and because of that short 10 minutes levels can become 30 or even 60 minutes long. PS2 version pretty much the same as PC one, but controls I think fit better for mouse and keyboard than joypad. So I have mixed feelings about this game. Story and setting interesting at first, but after some time becomes laughable. Fighting system pretty good, but lacks more complex combos and weapons are most useless, especially because enemy can easily knock it off from your hands. Levels all look the same, and too big and empty. Checkpoints very rare, so at times you need to replay big portions of the game for a stupid mistake, which sometimes not even your fault. Bosses too very primitive, especially computer terminal, but usual enemies can give you a lot of challenge, and fights with them can be very engaging. So game still has a charm, but better play PC version, because with such hectic fights, mouse much a better choice. This is all, see you in my next review, do not forget to like and comment. Matane!